Oh, thanks, Andri, for the introduction of this talk. So this is a great pleasure for me to present you this work. So this work is entitled ISS Stability and ISS Analysis for Linear and Nonlinear PD Systems. So we'd like to emphasize on Lyapunov methods for this work. And first, I have to say that I will mostly focus on linear PDEs. And I will give you at the very end of this talk some references on nonlinear PDEs. And so you will see how useful ISS analysis and design of ISS controllers could be useful for many control problems. So here is the outline of this talk. So first, I will start with some physical motivations, and I will state precisely the problem under consideration in this talk. Then I will deal with the design of boundary output feedback controller for hyperbolic PDEs, and I will give you some insight of design of controllers so that we have ISS properties of the closed loop systems. Then I will design some output feedback boundary controllers satisfying some property related to the sampling and also related to some quantization of the information. So to be more precise, I will design boundary controllers that are sampled with sample data. And depending only on sample data, and the boundary controller will be quantized in the loop. Okay, so we will see how useful ISS property could be for the design of such control laws. So first, some motivation. So I will recall you the very classical problem of flow control by using boundary controller of water inside of a reach. So here you see a picture of the height inside of the reach and of the flow rate inside of the reach. So both the height and the flow rate depends on the variables x and t. So x is the coordinate along the line 0, L. Okay. So this is the location of the point between 0 and L. And t is the time as usual. So here it is assumed that the flow rate, you see, does not depend on the location on the vertical direction, but only on the horizontal direction. Okay. So we assume that we have two boundary control, one at one gate, and we have one overflow spill weight at the beginning of the reach, and another one at the end of the reach. Okay, so the classical boundary control is how to design two overflow spillways controls, two overflow laws, so that the height and the flow rate converge to a given equilibrium. Okay, and to model this problem, I have classical nonlinear PDEs inside of that. So the first PDE is derived from the conservation of the mass. So it gives you the time derivative of the height plus the space derivative of this quantity, where Q is a flow rate and B is the width of the reach. Okay, so this is the width of the reach, which is assumed to be constant and does not depend on the X. Okay, so it is a constant reach, if you wish, a constant width. And the second equation is derived from the conservation of the momentum. Of course, both equations are coupled by the H and the Q. And the second equation gives you the time derivative of the flow rate plus the space derivative of this quantity, which is the flow rate at the power 2 divided by the channel width times the H, plus the gravity constant times the channel width times the square of H divided by 2. Okay, so this is the conservation of the momentum, this is the conservation of the mass, and this gives you a coupling system of two partial differential equations and they are non-linear because they are, you see the presence of the square here and the division by the 8. Okay, so the very general problem that is interesting for us today is to compute the position of the spillways, okay, both positions, so that you have a boundary control. So what does it mean? We like to have a boundary control so that the solution converges to the equilibrium. So what does it mean? It means that I would like to design two control actions depending only on the measure. So I don't want to find a control depending on the full state. So the full state is h and q for any x, okay? And the state at time t is just a function, a couple h and q. But I would like not to find an output that a control that depends only on the state, but on the full state, but depends only on measure. And here it is very natural in this context to say that you have two measures, the eight at the beginning of the reach and the eight at the end of the reach. Okay, so I would like to find two control actions that depend only on this part of the state. So this is a very partial information of the state. So I would like to find the solution of our model. So this is a mathematical problem, of course, but it is very important to prove that there exists a solution to our nonlinear PDE. So I would like also to prove that we have a convergence property. That means that the solution converge to the equilibrium with a stability property. Okay, so this is in addition to the attractivity property. And I would like also to guarantee a robustness respect to external disturbances. So robustness, it will be written in terms of ISS property. So ISS in the sense that disturbance stability property. Okay, disturbance to state stability property. And you will see that designing such a boundary controller will be very useful to design a quantized and sampler controller. So this is a property that will show you how ISS property can be useful for quantized and sample controller design. So first, I would like to start with a general hyperbolic PDE. So this is probably one of the most simpler infinite dimensional systems. So I have here the same dynamics as before, but here I have the state, which is now a vector of n equation, okay? And I have linearized version of the previous model. So what does mean? It just means that here the lambda, which is just a velocity matrix, is constant, okay? It is not a nonlinear function of the state. It is not a nonlinear PDE, it is just a linear transport equation where lambda, the matrix velocity, is a diagonal matrix n by n, and with only positive entries on the diagonal. So it gives us a matrices of positive velocities, and all the information goes from the left to the right, okay, from x equals 0 to x equals 1. So this is a typical picture of initial condition. So let us assume that the initial condition is like that. So this is the initial condition. And since the lambda is positive, all information are going to from the left to the right. Okay, so for positive time, you have the same shape as the initial condition, but which is moved a little to the right. But so what happens for small x. For small x, you cannot have a transport term. What appears is this information, it comes from the boundary condition. And to be more specific, the boundary condition at x equals 0 depends on what happens at x equals 1. So this is given by this green equation here. So what happens at x equals 0, it is a function, linear function, of the state at x equals 1 at time t, plus BU. So what does it mean? Just means that we have a boundary condition which is partially controlled through the control U and the control matrix B. Okay? So here, you see that with the boundary condition, you can compute fully compute the solution at given time, and when the time increases again, then you have to move from the left to the right again and again. So what about the measure? I would like to say that the measure is just the value of the state at the boundary, so at x equal 1, say, plus some disturbance, which is a given function, depending on the time only, which is not known, but we assume that it is bounded. Okay. So what is the statement of the problem is to find a control, a feedback controller, so it is a function, which is a functional, I should say, from the output only, so that we have this kind of dynamics. So here you see an ISS property, depending on the norm. So here I do not precise at all the norm, so it is just an introduction of this boundary control problem. So I would like to find the U here, so that the state at time t for a suitable norm is smaller than some exponential of the time. Okay, so it gives you something that goes to zero with times the norm of the initial condition plus the impact of the disturbance on the dynamics. Okay, so this is the typical problem of designing a new so that we have ISS property. Okay, and of course, depending on the norm that you have inside of that, the problem can be different. It can be different. Okay, for every norm that, or for every selection of norms that you have in mind. So here it is the problem that I would like to solve first. So first I would like to solve this problem without any disturbance. Without any disturbance, the picture is like that. So I would like to find u, so that u depends only on y. I do not have anymore the disturbance there. I would like to define just a control, which is just a static control. So I give me the output, I just multiply by matrix k, and this is my control. So to solve this boundary control problem for a linear hyperbolic system, it is very well known that we have a sufficient condition of this nice paper. And this necessary condition, this sufficient condition for the design of the matrix K is given by this notation. So G, I would like to denote G, which is just H plus BK. And rho of G is just the infimum of this quantity where here is the norm. Okay, so this is just a matrix norm that is derived from the Euclidean norm in Rn. I would like to pick the infimum for all diagonal and positive matrix D. Okay? And this paper give us a design condition for K for the closed loop system. So here the plant is given by this PDE, the controller is given by this static equation. Okay? And this condition, this sufficient condition is as follows. So if the matrix K is so that the rho of G is strictly less than 1, then the closed loop system is exponentially stable in L2 norm. Okay, so this is the result that I would like to show you and to prove today. And the proof is very, very easy in this case. And it is more complex for quasi-linear systems. But in this context, this is quite simple. I would like to show you. And this proof will be also instrumental to prove ISS property, to derive ISS stabilizer. So first, what is the proof? So assume that rho of G is smaller than 1. Okay, so what does it mean? Recall that rho of G is just the infimum of over all diagonal positive definite matrix D, so that we have that. So if the infimum is strictly less than 1, it just means that there exists such a D. Okay, so that you have this inequality. So then in that case, if I define Q like that, where lambda is just the matrix velocity and lambda minus 1 is the inverse, then we have this wide inequality. Okay, so here it just means that this matrix is symmetric, positive definite. Okay, so then when my Lyapunov function candidate is given by this quantity, so this is just the square root of z with the Whiting matrix Q there and with an exponential of minus mu x here. Okay. And if I just compute, at least formally, but in fact it made sense very precisely, that let us compute v dot. So the v dot is just twice z dot, okay, times q z transpose. Okay, so by using the dynamics, I have this quantity, exactly using the PDE. And then I can integrate by part. So integrating by part by differentiating this quantity and integrating this one, I got this line. And this line is divided in two terms. The first term is in green. So why I have written that in green? Because it has a good sign. Actually, it is negative. Mu is selected positive. This quantity can be shown to be positive. And so with this minus, it gives you something which is negative. So this is good. This gives us, this makes the V dot negative. But what about the boundary term? In fact, the boundary term, it comes from the integration by parts. It is given by this quantity. So let us use now the boundary condition. So using the boundary condition, you can check that this quantity could be less or equal than zero. So if mu is significantly small. So if mu is significantly small, then there exists k, so that this quantity is less or equal than zero, and thus we have v dot smaller than minus mu times something which is related to v. Okay. So what does it mean? Just means that we get a sufficient condition for the design of matrix k, so that this function is a Lyapunov function. So here in the previous result, you have seen that we have used this kind of Lyapunov function candidate. So it gives us L2 stability, in fact, you see? So you have stability in terms of the L2 norm. But in fact, the exponential stability can be derived in other norms, like H1, H2, and so on. So it depends just on the choice of the Lyapunov function candidate. So we have not so many results for ISS property of hyperbolic systems. So of course, there are some result and a very nice result obtained by Sergei Gerkovsky, Andrei Miroshenko, and Fabian Wirth in particular. So here in this presentation, I would like to derive several ISS properties using Lyapunov function. Okay, and we will estimate the sampling effect and the quantized effect. So what about the sample controller? So I would like to consider a closed loop system should be subject to a quantizer and in the output and the input, okay? And let us assume that it is necessary to sample and hold. So for many applications, we do not have access directly to all the output. We need to sample and to quantize also the information. So we cannot control directly in the same picture as before, directly for any time, we need to sample the information, the input information, also the output information. And also we need to tweak the information. So this is the motivation coming from limited information for control systems. So here the objective in this context is to design asynchronous event-triggered sampling. So we need to design sampling times for output and input signals, and they should be determined based on certain event trigger strategies. So I would like also to design dynamic quantization. So we see that the quantizer effect will be dynamic. It will depend on the time. And I would like to do that so that we have asymptotic stability of the closed loop system. And I will show you in a few minutes how ISS property can be very useful for that. So just a slide about what happened for finite dimensional system. So for linear finite dimensional system, if I have a plan given by this equation, so here I do not have anymore a PDE, just a classical A, B, and C matrices triplet. And instead of computing a classic linear controller as given by this kind of expression where I have a combination of controller plus observer, I would like to compute a quantization version of that and a trig version of that. So the blue terms come from the trig of the input and of the output, and the Q, the green terms, comes from the quantization effect, sorry, of the output and also on the input. Okay, so the very classical problem for finite dimensional linear system is how to design the timers for the output, the timers for the input, and how to design the quantizing parameters in the input and on the output, so that we have the closed loop system. So this plant with this controller is asymptotically stable. So this problem has been already solved for several years, and here I give you some references on this quantization and this eventual control problem. So for finite dimensional systems, so here is the first paper, is probably this paper of Daniel Liberzon, and eventual control has been done in this paper, where there is an answer of this question: should we sample or we should not sample? So in this paper, there is also a feedback control design with a rate constraint, and this is a nice overview with many references in that. And the next blue references are all on eventual control. So here I would like to show that ISS Lyapunov method can be very useful for sample and contact control. And for joint design of sampling and of measure input using contact information is not so usual. So there is some works, in particular of Roman Postoyan and co-authors, where they have written a very nice survey and very complete survey from Lyapunov functions for that. But for hyperbolic system, it is not so usual. So here it is also one of the goal of today to do that. So here I would like to first focus on quantization problem, then focus on sampling effect. Okay, I will not combine both together. So here let us just show what happens with the sampling of the input. Okay, sampling of the input due to the linearity is the same as sampling of the output. Okay, so here I have an infinite, the same as before, the infinite dimensional plan P. Okay, here I have my linear hyperbolic system with the control UD that should be computed. And this UD comes from a linear controller which is sampled. Okay, so how can we find a dynamic trig control for the input? So to do that, I will use an ISS stability property to solve this problem. And to do that, I would like to use again the ISS Lyapunov function, which is as before, the same candidate as before. And so let us first remark that this function is a full state feedback function. Okay? But in fact, it could be written like that just by using that the Z is constant along all lines with the along all characteristic lines. So in other words, the Z is written in Riemann coordinates. Okay, so the V of Z is in fact a function of the output only and the past of the output. Okay, so we can think about the Lyapunov function as just a function of the output only. Okay, so this is an output function of the output and also on the past values of the output, where Q is just the diagonal of here. And lambda is a matrix velocity diagonal as before. Okay, so now let us see what happens. Okay, let us see what happens with the control. So now I would like to deal with the control same as before. So the G, remember that it is H plus BK. Okay, and D will be now the error that is due to the sampling. Okay, so D will be just the error that you are doing if you sample or if you not sample. Okay, and using an integration by parts and new inequality, which is just more or less the same as before, the technical proof that I gave a few minutes ago, I got this one, this inequality. So I have V dot smaller than minus 2 nu V plus rho of D square. Okay, for a suitable choice of nu and rho. Okay. So what does it mean? Here I have the effect of the stability, and here I have the effect of the disturbance, of the error due to the quantization. So this is exactly an ISS property. You see, you have ISS property from the quantization effect to the state, okay, stability property. So now let us do how to sample. And now how to sample, we have just to look on the ISS inequality, and the ISS equality can be written like that, and we use some idea of Paolo Tabuada to design sampling rule derived from this ISS inequality. And to be more precise, we introduce the increasing sequence of time instant tau g which is defined as follows. So tau 0 is just 0, and tau 1 is just the minimal time that you, the maximal time that you travel from the left to the right. So it is just 1 divided by minimum velocity. And tau j plus 1 is the infinite time, so that you have larger than tj, and so that this bracket, yes, are equal to 0. Okay? And to be more precise, in fact, I need just a small expansion, but here it is just for technical reasons. Okay, so I introduce this sequence, which is defined by an induction like that. Okay, so this will be my sampling of the control, which is derived from ISS property. And we got the following result. So if I define the control like that, so first I do not control, and then I sample the signal, and the plot with this control, could be shown that it has a unique solution for an initial condition, and it is globally exponential convergence. So what does it mean? Just means that you have this kind of inequality. So here I have, since I have an exponential term, I have just a decreasing property. Okay. So here we do not have any stability property. You see, we have just a decreasing property, and V decreases as an exponential. We do not have a stability. A stability property can be proved in a similar, but of course more involved way, as a paper of Nicolas Spitia, Yasson, and Miroslav, and their submission for Automatica, if I'm right. Okay, here I can skip that. So let us perform some numerical simulation just to illustrate that. So I would like to consider a 2x2 linear hyperbolic system of convergence law. So here it is the same as before, but here I have just 2 equations instead of n equations. Here it is my h, it is my b. The initial condition is given by this quantity, okay, this function. So this is just a polynomial, and for the first component, and a sinus for the second component. And we can check that the assumption is satisfied with this q, and the mu gives us a ISS Lyapunov function. And the first component is indeed converging, even if we tweak the control, and the second component as well. But you can see here the effect of the tweak. Okay, you see, without any triggering signal, we have exactly a decreasing property, and we have a more flat output. But here we have always triggering the input. So this is why we have small waves here. Okay. So here is the triggering condition. So for each wet ball, you have to trig. Okay, so after a trig, we start at 0, then we reach here. And this is the exponential that is considered in the technical inequality. Okay. So as soon as the red signal, the green signal is touching the exponential, we need to tweak. Okay, and here we can count the number of samplings that we need, the number of tweak, and we can check that we have a positive inter-execution time. So this is also a property. We do not have any Zander solution. Okay. So now let us deal with quantized control. So quantized control will be also shown to be very related to ISS property, but a different ISS property. And I hope to be in such a way convincing you that ISS is useful for many control systems. So let us consider this output again, and I would like to not to use directly the output, but just a quantized version of that. So here Q is a quantizer, okay? And what does mean a quantizer? It is just if the output, the nominal output, is smaller than some given MQ, then you may have an error of due to the quantization, which is bounded and given by delta Q. Okay. So what does it mean? Just means that you do not have access directly to the boundary value, but you have just a quantized version of that with a quantization error, which is given by delta Q. Okay. So the question is that when the initial condition is relatively small, so I will make that precise in a few minutes, is it possible to show the controller so that the output is bounded for any t? So to do that, I would like to show that ISS estimate, ISS inequality allows us to specify the data of the quantizer that is possible to to have for the quantization of the measure. Okay. So which ISS do we need? So for that, I would like to introduce the H1 norm. So for the previous part, I selected L2 norm, but here now I need H1 norm, which is just the L2 norm square plus the L2 norm of the space derivative of Z. Okay, and taking the square root of that. So I would like to use the Hagman-like inequality, which is given by this inequality. So it is just the maximal value of the Z is just bounded by boundary value of Z plus H1 norm of Z square. And the proof of that is not so difficult. We have just this quantity is smaller than it is smaller than this quantity and this one. So the control objective is to find U so that the solution exists in H1 space. So now my Sobolev space is no more L2 but H1. And I would like to show that the solution decreases in this space. So the solution decreases in that and that. So decreasing in this norms give us also decreasing in infinity norm. So I would like to skip the existence of solution just to focus on the stability part. So I would like to just to show the second item, not the first one today. So to do that, I would like to use dynamic control. So here is my plant as before. This is always the same. So here I have the measure, and here I have the perturbation, which will be due to the quantization of the output. So if in the presence of this boundary disturbance, I have the controller, which is given by that. Okay. So I will consider dynamic controller, and the output, in fact, that is used for the controller is just the output of the plant plus some boundary perturbation. Okay. And here I would like to show that I would like to emphasize, sorry, that D being bounded implies that eta is absolutely continuous. Okay. So here there is a typo, sorry. And I would like also to consider initial conditions that are compatible. So what does it mean? It just means that the initial condition of Z of the plant and the initial condition of the controller, okay, should be compatible. So it just means that this equation holds. So I would like to select. So the question now is to find F and G so that we have a stability property of the closed loop system. And to do that, I would like to consider a Lyapunov function which is divided in three terms. So the Lyapunov function will be denoted by V. It will be defined on H1 cross Rn. So Rn is just due to the fact that in my previous slide, I have the state here, which is in H1, and here the state will be in Rn, okay? I have a dynamic controller. So the V is just a sum of three terms. So here it is the same as before, so just the L2 norm. Here it is just the L2 norm as well of the space derivative, that it does exist on H1. And here it is just a quadratic function, not of the state exactly, but of the state minus Z1. Okay, why is it interesting? Is that because, in fact, eta, it is natural to make eta not converging to zero, but converging to the true output that we would like to track. Okay, so we can check, of course, it is not very difficult, that V, it can be sandwiched with the H1 norm plus L the square of this quantity. Yeah, R is just the usual norm in Rn. And our objective is to find such inequality, such ISS inequality with this norm. So here we have the V dot smaller than the minus sigma of this V plus the effect of the disturbance. So the linear controller that I would like to define, to introduce, is not a fully general non-linear controller, it's just this kind of linear controller. So I would like to design alpha and k so that the linear controller is given by this linear dynamics. So it will be a linear, yeah? Okay, so I can derive a matrix and a condition, okay, a condition on this parameter alpha, k, and blah, blah, blah. So that, and I can show that if this condition is satisfied, then the previous Lyapunov dissipation holds. Okay, so the previous ISS property holds. And this is very important and very useful for the quantization property. Using this ISS inequality, we can show that if we select M and Q like that and the quantization like that, then we can show that there exists a constant C so that the norm of Z1 is smaller than C, and we got the following result. Assuming that the previous assumption, the assumption of the previous theorem hold, then assume that the initial condition satisfies this quantity, so it is my smallness property of the initial condition, and assume that M and delta Q are defined logs so that this inequality holds, then we can show that we have this inequality. So V does not go to zero. There is no hope to converge to zero because of the quantization effect, but V becomes small, okay? So you do not reach exactly zero, you reach to a ball around zero, and the radius of this ball is given by this quantity and with the Lyapunov function V. So just a small illustration to give you the flavor of that, of this problem. So again, I consider a 2x2 hyperbolic systems. And here I have my data, and here I just select a first quantizer. So for that, we can see that the solution converges to zero, in fact, with this quantizer. And I see that, okay, here I have the evolution of the of some part of the state, and you see that you do not converge to zero. In fact, it is not very easy to see that, but you do not converge to zero, you converge to neighborhood of zero. But modifying the size of the quantizer allows you to control the neighborhood of zero to which you are converging. So this is something that is clear from this equation. Okay, so you see here you converge to neighborhood of zero, which is given by the size of the neighborhood of zero is given by delta Q. Okay, so by selecting delta Q in a suitable way, you can converge to a large or small neighborhood of zero. So as a conclusion, it is clear now that ISS Lyapunov function is a key tool for the study of ISS property, of course, but also for the design of controllers and for many control applications. So this is very important now for control or infinite dimensional systems. So let us give you some additional references about non-linear infinite dimensional systems. So there is a current work of Sua Schrem and Francesco Ferrante. So Sua is preparing a PhD under the co-supervision of Francesco and myself, and there is a paper that will be followed by others probably, done with Sua, where you have some non-linearity effect and ISS property of such non-linear hyperbolic system. Okay, so non-linear comes from saturated boundary control. And what about non-linearity where it does not appear on the control? You can see this paper of Georges Bastin, Jean-Michel Coron, and Amaury Ayat. So this is a very nice paper dealing with ISS. So ISS is included in the title of this paper. For quasi-linear hyperbolic system, as the one that I presented on the beginning of this presentation. So for non-linear systems, ISS property is not so well developed, but it does exist already some work. And so here in this presentation, I consider only hyperbolic system, but in fact, a parabolic system can be also very useful for application. ISS of parabolic system is also crucial. And in this SIAM review that I show you, there are many references where you have such ISS property of parabolic system using Lyapunov functions. So Lyapunov function for ISS is not only for hyperbolic system, but also for other kind of systems. So this SIAM paper will appear in a few weeks. But if you wish, you can already download it from the webpage of the authors. So this is the conclusion of my talk. I would like to thank you for your attention And thank you again, Andre, for the co-organization of this workshop.